MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon. Luke Weaver will be on the mound for game four. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you could throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
And now is Yasiel Puig. He will lead this one off today.
For Colorado, the left
first year. Pitch of the at-bat. And that's in there for strike one. Well, guys, these Diamondbacks, as they begin play, they do come in fresh off a victory last time out, but they've been giving ground in the division of late. They've won just twice in their last seven games.
Yeah, Matty B. And you know what, Hero? This is when you really get tested. They call it the dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more. Especially the way this team is underachieved. You got to keep grinding. You got to find a way to put your foot on the gas and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
Big swing, but he just gets a piece of it. Strike one. Wind up and the 0-1.
0-1.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
Line towards center field, and that'll be a base hit for Zobrist.
Batting third, the right fielder, number 19.
So striding forward now, Charlie Blackmon. And the home-away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. And a curveball in for a strike.
I know it's the first inning, but he better find his release point on that breaking stuff or he's in for a long day.
Fouled away. A pause and the 0-2. And a cut fastball here that he started off a bit too far inside. It nearly got him.
What makes hitting so difficult is covering both sides of the plate. And that hard pitch right there that was inside makes it awfully tough now to cover both the inside and the outside part of the plate.
So he gets him swinging on a pitcher's pitch. Charlie Blackmon goes down for out number two in the top half. First pitch on its way. Jesus Aguilar stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. One and one to the Rockies' first baseman. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on it. One and two.
Guess who tipped their hand? They were sitting all over a piece of cheese. He flew open on the front side.
Runners off for second. Still one and two as he fouls it away. Look now the pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
Hit on the ground to third. Right to him. Second for the force out and the side is retired. One left for Colorado. And now Arizona gets its first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. John Gray gets the start for Colorado in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
First-round draft pick out of the University of Oklahoma. Big arm, 95 to 98 miles an hour. Good hard slider. It's never been about the stuff for John Gray. It's about attacking the strike zone. At times gets a little bit too timid on the mound, but if he brings his A game, you'll know early. If he's throwing strikes early with that fastball and he's in an attack mode, he's as good as anybody in the game.
1-1 to the D-backs leadoff man. Individual matchup numbers against John Gray. He's gone just 2 for 13. He's taken him deep once.
probably better that he let that pitch go anyway. After seeing a lively fastball on the pitch before, it's pretty hard to sit back enough on a well-thrown changeup.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Hit hard, but foul. The 2-2 one more time.
We got 3-2.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with. A long at bat like this in the first inning can reveal a lot.
And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game. Now at play, Tim LeCastro. He drove in the other of their two runs last night. There's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. Now it's 2-0.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
Big cut at the 2-0 slider, but he comes up empty, 2-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. And he missed with it here, so now it's a full count, 3-2. Marte gets his lead at first, nobody out. This is line to left. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is called in for the first out.
Batting first.
Stepping in, David Peralta. He's carrying a batting average of just over 300, so clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. Relayed to Aguilar, the double play, and that retires the side. An inning in the books, no score here on the show. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Chris Owings. Ready. Here's the first offering. And he fouls this one off. The wind up and the 0-1. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
Pitcher's got options here. He looked a little bit out front. Might be able to rush a fastball by him.
Two-strike breaking ball there, but this will wind up missing. It's 1-2.
That turns out to be a good take on that front door breaking ball, but you have to wonder if that pitch buckled him at all. That was really close to clipping the inside corner.
The 1-2. Looked at for ball number two.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Got him. Carter Kieboom digs in now. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for.
0-1.
Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. Strike called. Tough to do much with that one. Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Kelly goes to get it. Makes the throw to first. Two down. The bases are empty here with two gone, and in the bat next it'll be Tyler Naquin. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss that time, it's 0-1.
Ball and strike.
Now the 1-1 pitch. He pops it up. Here comes Peralta. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. He'll get it into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
As we look again at that double here, you can see that he was thinking too right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
Digging in now, Tony Walters. And there's a look at his home and road splits so far this year. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
Great execution of that changeup right there. Great arm action. Batter was totally out front on that.
Fouled off. No score here as we play inning number two. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2.
He has to be greedy working the outside of this strike zone. He cannot allow this guy to get back in his count, especially with the pitcher on.
Hit softly down the line at first. From the stretch, the 1-2. Popped up. Vargas waits on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Danger averted following the two-out double. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. Eduardo Escobar standing in. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night.
Eduardo Escobar.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch. Wind up the 2-0 pitch. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
Ooh, that's a good pitch to take a hack at right there. Changeup up in the zone. He'd like to have that one back.
And it's fouled away. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Down the first baseline. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now the pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. Owings is in. And the throw on the first will take care of him. So he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away.
The first baseman.
Set to get his day started. Kevin Cole. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year. Looking to get things turned around in a hurry. Sent on the ground out to second. Diving try, but it's through into the outfield.
Take a look at this right here. He can get jumped here trying to pull it down the left field line. Stayed in there, fought hard, grinded out a nice stop the other way.
From the stretch, swing and a liner, but gloved by the third baseman for the out.
Batting ducks, the catcher.
Digging in, Carson Kelly is back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Way late on the fastball for strike one. Grounded up the first baseline. On the back with it is Aguilar, and that'll retire the side. One left for Arizona, who moved to the third with no score. Standing in, John Gray. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
Number 55, John Gray.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Peralta is under it. One out.
Now batting, the left fielder, Yasiel Puig.
Next to bat will be Yasiel Puig. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he misses inside with that one. Ball one.
Bullpen.
Won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Now the pitch. 3-0 now.
No strike.
Ben Zobrist waits on deck. Three and one to the Rockies left fielder. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And there are two away now.
Now batter, second baseman, Ben Zobrist.
Ready for another chance? Ben Zobrist, one for one after a single his first time up. Here's the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Back goes Rojas. Great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump. This guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling the baseballs. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good.
Here's Charlie Blackman now. Now this is foul tipped at home plate, and that might have shot directly at our home plate umpire because he's moving a little gingerly back there. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Blackman behind, no balls and two strikes. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fouled away.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Here's the 0-2. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Rockies strand one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. So coming to the plate, Josh Rojas. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three. In there, 0-1.
0-1.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. On the move is Puig. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down.
Batting nine.
So with one gone in the inning, we'll take a look at where these guys sit in the standings. And I think they can pretty much start to think about next year because they are well back in the division race. Standing in, Luke Weaver. First delivery to him on the way. Low for ball one. To first. And a take to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting, center fielder, Starling.
Digging in to try it again, Starling Marte. Second trip to the plate for him. He drew a leadoff walk in the home first. Bouncer to the left side. Fielded cleanly. Go over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Diamondbacks down in order. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. So here's the cleanup. Jesus Aguilar. We begin the top of the fourth. Here comes the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low scoring pitcher's duel for once.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Nope, outside.
Line drive to left. Peralta is there and he makes the catch for the out. Good time now to check out the Diamondbacks Road to the Show report. As you see, a couple of guys in the upper levels of the minors that have been making waves as of late. Here's Chris Owings now. as he swings and lifts it in the air out to shallow right field. Rojas come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
Now batting.
Now with the plate, Carter Kieboom, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
First delivery to him on the way.
I know it's cliche and it's tired at times, but a well-located fastball down at the knees is still the best pitch in the game.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder giving chase, and no one will track it down. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Scooped up, throw in time, and the side is retired. So nothing happening this time around. To the bottom of inning number 4 we go, and we are tied nothing-nothing. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Stepping up as the shortstop, Tim LoCastro.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Kieboom's got it, and there's one away.
Now batting, left fielder.
So one away here with the bases empty. And up next, the outfielder, David Peralta. Hit hard to third. First will get him, already two away in the home court.
The third baseman, number 5.
Stepping in and ready for another shot. Eduardo Escobar. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Lays off 1-0. No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. And that misses low and inside. 2 balls and no strikes. Now the 2-0. Belted high and deep into right center. Naquin looks up. Into the pool area and gone. Solo shot to right center. Number 25 for him on the year. And the Diamondbacks strike first. It's 1-0.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
Into the box now, Kevin Cohn,
the first baseman.
He'll take a breaking ball in off the plate for ball one. Base hit in his first trip. Couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. 2 out, nobody on. 1-2 now.
2 strikes down.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Diamondbacks hit the board first thanks to this solo home run. We're through 4. It's now 1-0 Arizona. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the 5th.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Rockies skipper Bud Black between innings, specifically about his club's offensive output to this point. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out there on that train. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Home run number 15 for him thus far, as the Rockies pull even now at 1 apiece.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Now batting.
Now they bring up Tony Walters.
Walker.
As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Big swing, but a little dribbler here to the right side of the mound. On the first, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball. Now first out.
The pitcher. John.
Now at the plate, John Gray. One run in and one gun so far in this inning. And he takes ball one. One run, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. Well, should be 2-0, but he goes way out of the zone to go after that one, and it's even 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Peralta is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting, the left fielder, Yasiel Puig.
So two are gone in the Rockies' half of the fifth. And up next, the right-handed bat of Yasiel Puig. Good curveball there, gets the swing and miss. Good cutter there, and he's got him behind the eight ball now, 0-2.
Hey, nice job of bouncing back after the leadoff homer. Two quick outs after the bomb, and he's got a chance to get out of this.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball. Not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
The 1-2.
Ball two.
Hey, started this guy backwards, couple of off-speed pitches early, followed by back-to-back heaters. He can go either way he wants to go right now.
And he chased it in the dirt. And that ends the inning. But the Rockies are able to knock things up thanks to this solo home run. On to the bottom of the fifth, all even now at 1-1. And back in Phoenix as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production. And he said they just aren't putting enough competitive at-bats together right now. He thinks they need to slow the game down a little bit when they get into the box. Top to bottom, they're hitting into way too many outs early in the count and not letting the at-bats develop. He's all for picking on a good pitch to hit when it comes, but they need to make sure they're doing more damage on the swings that they're taking.
0-2.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Now changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Now usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you call that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1. One out, nobody on. That softly hit to right. Will that get down? Nope. A nice job by the retreating first baseman to look it in for the out. At the plate, Josh Rojas. He flew out in his last at bat. Way behind that pitch, it's 0-1. Taken close that time, but it's 1-1.
That's not a bad pitch right there. That two-seamer moving away from a left-handed hitter. Didn't get the strike, but I like the idea behind the pitch.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. We played five full, tied at one aside.
Merrill
Kelly takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
number 29.
Top half of the sixth about to get started. And set to go is the second baseman, Ben Zobrist. And he fouls this one off. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Now a shot toward the gap in left center. And he is in the second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
Now batting.
Oh, this is a great way to start hitting. Now the go-ahead run is on second. A base hit away from coming across. I know it's only the sixth inning, but you'd love to claim the lead right now and let your bullpen carry the load the rest of the way.
Charlie Blackmon is in for the third time here as he watches one that misses low. It's a ball and no strikes. The 1-0. It's a fastball that misses. Kelly features one of the biggest yakkers in the game. Curveball's got a ton of movement. Outside, 3-0 now.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. 3-1.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. After it is Marte. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double.
Now that.
And this thing bounces over the wall, but I don't think it would have mattered if it stayed in the ballpark. Either way, the runner was going to score, and he was going to wind up in second. He drove that ball really nicely.
So now to the plate, Jesus Aguilar. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. A 1-1 pitch. No one out with a runner at second. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. And he can't even get a glove on it. Throw goes over to third, and they've got the runner trapped in a hot box between second and third now. He is out, retreating to second as they slap the tag on him. Two-two. Swing and a ground ball to third. And there's out number two.
Had to protect there with two strikes, and he just got it off the end of the bat. Not much of a problem for the infield at that point.
Into the box now, Chris Owings. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. Oh, you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now.
Down 0-2, maybe simplify the game plan right here. Get on the heater.
Bullet to second base, a fine play, and that ends the inning. Rockies do get a run in the inning on this RBI double. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's now 2-1 Colorado.
Number 53. Walker.
A little bit of fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. The average coming in, 257. We have 19 homers and 67 runs batted in. Fastball at 96 on the radar gun, and it's 1-1. 1-2 as he chases the slider. Walker, a native Pennsylvanian, he was a fourth-round selection during the first-year player draft of 2012.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy, drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way in the big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
And oh, strike three called on a fastball that looked inside from here, but that's out number one.
Well, that call looked like it was a little up pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Starling Marte
is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. Seared down the first baseline. Dives, but he can't pull it in, and it's down the line into right. Around second, he's on his way to third, and he's in there easily. It's a stand-up triple. He's into third with his sixth three-bagger of the year.
Yeah, and that tells you what kind of an offensive player he is. Very good at hitting the ball on the line, and obviously he's got some decent wheels on him too.
Set and the pitch. Tim LoCastro comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. Scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Here's the ball low. He misses with a changeup. Hit the other way out toward right field. Blackman is under it, makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And this will get into the books as a sack fly and an RBI, and we are tied at two.
That was a good controlled swing out of him there, and that's exactly what he was hoping to do. Get it into the outfield and pick up the RBI.
Ready once again, David Peralta. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one.
Time to be aggressive with these hitters now. After that sack fly, now it's time to try to get out of this inning with only one run scored.
This is on the ground over the first. He's on the bag with it is Aguilar, and that'll retire the side. So one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Seventh inning coming up, and we are tied 2-2. Mike Lee is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number eight.
Striding in for the Rockies, Carter Kieboom. Third trip to the plate for him here. He struck out and grounded out in his first two tries. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hit down the third baseline, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch rolled slowly down the third baseline, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
Hard hit ball to second. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit.
Well, that's just a case, D-Roll. You've got to make a little bit better pitches. Now two strikes, jumps ahead, 0-2, and then a couple of foul balls on pitch number five. He squares one up for a base hit.
Yeah, I can't tell you how nice it feels right there. You battle.
Meanwhile, here, the throw down to second is not in time, and it's a stolen base. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss for strike one. Here comes the 1-1.
Yep, that ball went out.
Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with nobody out. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Rojas settles under it, and there's one away. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
Number 14,
Tony.
Now to the plate, Tony Walters, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Here comes the first pitch. Lee, a 32-year-old veteran. He's an 11-year vet at the major league level, so he certainly put together a nice career in professional baseball.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full pitch.
One home. This is flared out towards second. And this will be put away easily for the out.
Carpenter
come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 13, Matt Carpenter.
And that misses for ball one. One and oh, here it is. Carpenter out in front of it here as he pulls this one foul into the seats down the right side. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. One and two, here it is. Still a ball and two strikes. Two pitch.
Hey, having a B right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Ready with the 1-2. Now a little dribbler here off to the right side of the mound. On the first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. One left for Colorado. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Ryan Borucki gets the ball from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seven.
Number 56, Ryan.
The last bet that many. We heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hey!
You got to cover the whole plate now after letting him steal two strikes on the inside half.
Hit out towards second. Zobrist has it. On the first, and that is a big out to lead off the home seven.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Stepping in, Kevin Cohn. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. One low as he's able to lay off the slider. One ball and one strike for the Diamondbacks first baseman.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a blue shin or a ground out to the left side.
The 2-1 home. Line toward the alley in left center. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. Not in time. He's in there with a double.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it. He's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Ready now, Carson Kelly. It's his job to get something into the outfield and give that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. No balls and one strike. Ready with the 0-1.
Whoa,
lays off for ball one. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher to facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
2-1. Here it is. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Here's the game within the game. You have a better matchup on deck. You've got a 3-1 count in this situation. Don't be afraid to put him on base and attack the next guy.
Full count now. 3-2. Fouled off. He's set. The 3-2. Drilled on the ground at short. And that will just elude his outstretched glove for a base hit. And the go-ahead runs in to score as they break the tie. It's 3-2. And he'll get there without a play. It's a stand-up triple.
The right fielder, number 10. Yeah.
Nelson Gonzalez takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this.
41, Nelson Gonzalez.
To the plate now, Josh Rojas, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. So far this season, with runners in scoring position, Rojas is below the Mendoza line. Batting average under 200, unfortunately.
Matty, he struggled against right-handed pitching all season.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Diamondbacks get one, and it comes on the RBI triple. We'll march on to the eighth. It's now 3-2 Arizona. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Archie Bradley will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. He's into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number 56.
Yasiel Puig is in to start things off as he looks at a ball to start the inning, 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1. Fastball catches the black there for a called strike.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. A base hit in the center field. We'll see if they have something in the works here with the leadoff hitter aboard and a guy that can really handle the bat in the number two spot.
Now that second leadoff hitter finds his way on base. Should be interesting to see the cat and mouse with the manager. Does he use the bunt right here? Can he put a little hit and run on?
Do we go one?
And he's in the second safely with the stolen base. Set with the 0-1. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Weak grounder back to the mound. And that's the first down.
The right fielder.
Fastball off the plate away for ball one. The average has been good. 306 to start the day. Two home runs and 11 RBIs. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. This one, everything we could have hoped for. 3-2 in inning number 8. grounded to first. He's got it. And a step out first for the out, three unassisted. Into the box now, Jesus Aguilar. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Hey, I don't have a problem with him taking a pitch right there. It's a good opportunity to see what he's got. Also a good opportunity to see if he's going to be pounding the strike zone.
But pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. Rockies strand one. Still a 3-2 ball game.
Akil Badu
will stick around as he'll take over in right field. Striding into the box, Cole Calhoun is getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Edge of the zone that time, taken and ruled a strike. Swing and a line drive, but just fouls as he just misses extra bases. Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Bounces to the left side, and that's through for a hit. So it's a good start to the inning for the Diamondbacks. Leadoff hitters aboard. The tag, and he is out at second.
Well, clearly they challenged a guy they shouldn't have right there. He's got a missile launcher for an arm, so when he saw him trying to stretch a double, he unleashed one to cut him down. So probably won't be doing that again in this one.
Digging in next will be Starling Marte. As he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier, making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
Curveball just about rung him up, but it's to 2-2.
Regardless of the result right here, to be down 0-2 and work it back to an even count, got to feel like it's a win for the offense.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Starling Marte comes out number two this inning. Into the box, Tim DeCastro. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Great job of changing speed here. It's 0-2.
Wow, what makes it so tough to be a hitter is to be able to hit and change his speeds, right? You're geared up for the fastball, and all of a sudden, he pulls the string and throws it.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Diamondbacks down in order, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Andrew Chafin takes the ball now. Number nine looking to close the door. Nate Lowe will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here. Nothing in one. Chafin is adjusting to the new normal as MLB now mandates that relievers reach the end of an inning or face three or more batters before being replaced. For a one-time lefty specialist like this, that's a big change.
Hey, this guy's so aggressive, I don't think this pitch is anywhere near the zone.
And the slider's one in ball. The dirt as he lays off it for a ball. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here on the ninth. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout. Now.
pinch hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
And a sinker gets too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. The average right at 280 coming in. Four home runs and a dozen RBIs. Ball and no strikes, here it is. Takes this the other way to right. And that'll take care of a pinch hitter here for out number two.
Now that the center fielder.
Now with the play, Tyler Naquin. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. The win would be Mike Leake's if our current score holds up. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1.
That's a ball.
One-run game here in the top of the ninth. Line to the right side. But this is taken in as a perfect metaphor to end this one as that ball was hit hard, but the ball game is over.
Hey, it always feels good to win a baseball game, but when you can win one at home in front of your home crowd, all those fans cheering, this is a good win for this team.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. The Diamondbacks get their 20th home win this year. Mike Leake wins in relief for the eighth time this year. Andrew Chafin records the save, his 28th on the season. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watkin, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Welcome to Fire Sale Gaming, powered up by FireSaleGames.com. So just shop our website, FireSaleGames.com, and get you a fire sale of a deal on some video games. We also got some books, DVDs, CDs, whatever you want. FireSaleGames.com.
We about to turn it on. Turn it on.